Up next on the bench for the midweek build is Tamiya's 1/24th scale Honda S600. This would be about a 1965 model, 600cc engine. Honda knew how to make sweet quality motor cars as well as motorcycles back in the day. So you've got some options in here. You paint it red or white. We got the white with the red interior, which is what I like. We're going to take a look at everything inside the box. ModelRoundup.com sent this over for the show. I will link down in the description. They have this in stock in this exact moment, and you can snag one for yourselves. So first, let's look at the plain plastic. We have a silver parts tree for the brake drums, for the discs. We've got our engine and transmission package, our headers. We got our little pedals there. This is a very, very small car, so the parts are going to correlate with that. But check out Tamiya's molding quality. Some of you only know Tamiya as a military modeling company, but they make hundreds and hundreds of model motorcycles and cars and trucks. So what they produce is very high quality. We've got the door panels there. Check out how nice and prominent everything is. We've got our dashboard. Look at the gauges on there. All right, we've got the top of our dashboard with the vents molded open. We've got our floor pan here. We'll flip it over and look at the other side with all that grip texture for the driver and their passenger. We got a beautiful frame here. All the mounting locations have large holes on the Tamiya kits. There's no guesswork. Check out the underhood detail. And it's all molded as one large piece, so you could paint it up separate, detail it, and install it into the model. Excellent detail on this little tiny car. When you see the body, you're just going to giggle. There we've got our battery system. We've got our suspension. We've got part of the rear. We've got our radiator here. Little baby shock absorbers. Steering. I'm guessing if that's pinned like that, then it probably has posable steering if you choose to build it as such. We'll pull over the other or the final large parts tree. We got our wheels. And this is actually the outside of the wheel. Don't let that fool you. That goes to the inside of the car. This is the outside where they bow out. And in these little holes here, we'll accept the hubcaps so that you'll get that look when you're done. That's what that's for. We've got our hood, which opens because this has an engine. We've got our differential and drive shaft. We've got our up top. We've got our tonneau cover. We've got rear suspension driveline parts. We've got our spare. We've got a beautiful steering wheel. Look at the molding on that. Two nice bucket seats. Not going to fit more than that. I'm pretty sure this is the cylinder head. Or this is the carburation, maybe. Definitely the exhaust right here. A little dual exhaust on this little tiny car. Look at all those pipes all come together. And it's molded open. The amount of attention they put into this. I also see another set of brake drums and another set of discs. We got some steering spindles. And look at that little body. That's my hand right there, of course. We've got molded in parts for the up top, the gas cap, the door handles, our windshield wipers, our hood latch, all of that molded open. Look at that cute little nose. Vents are open. Grille position, look at the grille position. They put little detents on either side. And then they've got holes for the bumper to mount. All the different mounting locations for taillights and equipment on the back. No guesswork with these kind of kits. Excellent deep molding on those door panels. You could easily get a marker in there and do your washing or some Tamiya paint wash. Now we'll go to the other side of the desk and look at what they include. They have what are called poly caps. These will help us install our wheels when we're all done. They'll just slide in there so there's no breaking wheels off and stuff. We've got a chrome tree here. Check out those bumpers. There's your hubcaps with the Honda H's. We've got, looks like, rearview mirrors. We've got a grille, and the grille is molded open, even though it's that small. You don't have to blackwash that or anything. We've got our headlight buckets. Windshield wipers, be very careful. Looks like we got our windshield brace here. Door handles. shifter, rear view mirror, gas cap. Yikes. Picked a bad week to build that when my hands are giving me problems. We got our windshield. The frame will have to be painted, which I can do. It's chrome with black surround. So we can do Sharpie marker in black all the way around, and then we can do a Molotow or another Sharpie on the inner trim. And that's how we can get that all done on there. We've got a clear up top. So if you wanted to, you could mask off the glass because it's got the little side windows in this one. So you can do it like that. We've got our back glass for the other convertible top we showed. Headlights, turn signals, marker lights, and whatnot. All on that big tree there. So this is pretty cool. If you want to mask that off, you can get a cooler looking with the side glass. Those little side lights on the back. So that's pretty interesting there. We've got a nice set of tires. They are solid, which is common for Tamiya. They are a vinyl rubber texture. They have a nice tread to them with no brand name on either side. Again, which is a common thing. We've got a minuscule set of decals and silver chrome appliques. This is actually a backing paper and a clear carrier, and you will put those chrome logos on the car in the right positions, like on the fenders and stuff, and then you won't have to try to paint any of that stuff. Then we've got waterslide decals for the S600. We've got license plates if you choose to use them, dash gauges, steering wheel centers, and our hood ornaments and everything. If you do the white car, you use the red. If you do the red car, you use the white, so on and so forth. So water slide, very, very small. If you're not too familiar with Tamiya kits, their manuals are absolutely superb. All the drawings are in mint condition. They leave you no guesswork as to where parts go most of the time. They just tell you everything's going to be here. These are the colors. These are where all the decals go, and this is how you get it assembled. Also, a nice thing in the boxes that they always include is a sheet of background information on the vehicle in numerous languages. There you can read the whole history of the S500s, the 250cc cars, the 360cc cars. I mean, motorcycles have bigger engines than most of these little cars did back in the day, but I bet they were an absolute blast to cruise around in. So I'm going to start gluing together my sick S600. And I'll be right back. Thank you. While the parts are small, Tamiya makes the build pretty easy. We get to build up the entire chassis, the engine and transmission, the radiator and the battery. We even get to add the pedals to it and some stuff to the interior before we head over to the paint department. Now, you saw me adding tape to the back here. I want the hood to match. This is such a small car, so I want the hood to make sure that we get it all painted together when we do that white coat of paint that you saw in the thumbnail. So I just taped it underneath the bottom. Towards final assembly, there's a bracket that goes in here, and I will glue that into place. That bracket is right here by the door panels. That will go in place and be glued in with super glue so that I can continue to open the hood for display of the model. So we'll get that all painted together. Also, they were smart when they made this body brace molded in. They actually attached it below where the door panels will be when we're done. So I can leave that in there so when I put my body holder on there, my Tamiya paint stand, it won't split the body or stretch it too far. I can leave that support in there until I'm all done with all of that. Then I glued the dashboard together. The dashboard will be all one color based on the box art and the instructions. And then inside the gauge cluster, we'll get it painted along with the little instruments and the latch for the glove box. Then we will put our decals on there and get those all in there. It's a convertible, so we're going to be able to see inside. I got the steering wheel column and steering wheel glued together. Love that little open steering wheel. That'll go inside there when we're done. The top will be painted body color. This is the hard top, so all I need to do is the trim around it when I'm done and glue that window in, but we'll be painting that up. The interior tub is a darker color. What's real nice is the instructions tell you, but they also give you an overhead view of the car so you can see how to paint stuff up. So this area back here will be the same color as the seats. The floor will be the darker color, and then I'm going to do the bottom in the body color. What I'll do is I'll prime it all with black and then mist the white over, so we'll get some really cool shadows and see the texture of the body like that underneath, but it'll still be the body color. Then on this tree here, I'll be priming the wheels and the exhaust and the tonneau cover with a black, but then I will remove the tonneau cover and spray the wheels and the exhaust with a nice silver color so those line up. We've got our under hood, which again, according to the picture here and the manual color call out, is the same color as the body. But to make it stand out, I will once again primer this in black for shadows and then give it a little bit of a lighter coat of white than I do for the body and the hood and the top. The seats are going to be red on mine. The door panels will be red on mine because I just like that box art look. The radiator and the battery are one piece and they will attach to the front of the chassis when we're done, just before we put it all together. That's of course going to get painted black as they request. And then the engine will be painted one metallic color and then hand painted for accents with carburation, air cleaner, belt and pulley system. We'll just have to paint that pulley by hand and the belt and all that, and we will be ready to go with the engine and transmission, which just drops into the chassis that we saw. The chassis builds up nice. The wheels are steerable. That's all brake drums on this thing. They just for some reason must have needed to use up some sprue space and did them in silver. But yeah, it's drums all the way around, which I should have figured for an older Honda like that, they would have used that. We've got our drive line in here. It's all going to be a basic black with a little bit of silver metallic accents. And you can see how nice that goes together with that suspension, the way they have that set up with the gear drive and all that. That's pretty interesting. It's almost like a portal axle. We've got our shock absorbers on there. We've got our steering and our suspension, and they made that small chassis very, very detailed, so I did enjoy it. That all went together super easy. I'm going to head over to the paint booth on the silver parts tree. We still have the radiator fan for the front of the engine. We've got our radiator cap and our shifter. I'm just going to leave those the silver as they are because they look nice as they are. And then we've got all those lovely chrome pieces, which won't be touched till we start working on stuff towards the end. I'm going to head over to paint, and I will see you over there. So far, so good on the S600. You can see how I did that windshield. Super easy. Wasn't a big fight like it would be if you tried some, you know, chrome and stuff like that. I just do it with the markers. It looks fine, but you could do it your way because it's your model. We've got the hard top done. This is just ready to go on the car. I used the future floor polish to hold the glass in on this one because the frame's real thin. And then we did the light chrome trim around it. So as an option that can sit on top, kind of looks like a little Corvette kind of thing. We got our tonneau cover on, and that's just done in a flat black, which gives it flat black, kind of almost does have a semi-gloss sheen to it and whatnot. That looks cool. We've got the dashboard done and glued in. You saw how that popped in from the bottom. We got our steering wheel attached, got our hood glued on. Got our interior fenders in there, all mounts from the bottom. On the body, when I finally get the body on the chassis, we'll do the windshield wipers, we'll do the glass last, we'll do the door handles, the trunk hinges, the fuel cap, all that stuff off the chrome tree. We will get on the car. We can see how I did the taillights, the grille, and the reverse lights are all done up with Sharpie markers, and then we use that floor polish again to glue it in place, because they're just thin small parts. When we get done with the car, we have it all together. I'll have to attach the headlights, windshield wipers, door handles, trunk hinges. We've got some side mirrors if you choose to put them on, bumpers, and our hubcaps on those nice wheels. We'll attach that all after we get the body on the chassis. The chassis looks lovely. So far has gone together without any fighting. We got that little 600cc Ford banger. We got our radiator mounted in. Look how nice that lines up with the radiator line right to the engine. Got our battery next to it. We got those cool looking metal wheels. And then underneath the chassis, that white does look nice with the black underneath it. Lots of shadows and stuff. The chassis, the wheel and tire, the exhaust package all just snaps into place and glues in without issue. Those door panels look great. The seats, the black interior, the red of the interior folding over the back, and then you saw me hand paint that. So super easy assembly so far. Looks like the body's gonna fit very tightly. I'm gonna have to spread the body out quite a ways without breaking the dashboard loose from the top of the chassis to get that on. But once that's on, all our locating holes for the bumpers, the headlights, the grille even has locator marks. All that stuff will help me quite a bit. I will then apply the last of the teeny remaining decals. I will apply the chrome badges, as we saw during the parts reveal, and then I will give it a couple brushed on coats of future floor polish to seal everything down, and we will have that final. Well, I don't want to act like I'm talking to a little baby, but just look at how cute this little Honda S600 is. Holy cow. I asked Model Roundup to send this one over for the show, and they graciously did. This thing is adorable. Don't talk too loud. You'll wake the little baby. It is so, so cute, and it goes together quite easily. All the little chrome pieces, you think those would give you fits putting them on, but they all have locator holes except for the mirrors. The mirrors have very wide bases. They're scale, but they're wide. They go right up against the chrome dress rail on the side of the chassis, so you don't even have to worry about it. I used a drop of gel super glue on each mirror and just stuck it on the fender up in front like it shows right there, and they just stuck where they were in one try. Gave it a coat of future floor polish. The windshield dropped into place in its little groove. I used a bead of Mod Podge, like you've seen me use on glass before, and it just laid in there and held itself up. It didn't need to be braced or anything. I attached the windshield brace and the mirror. I did smudge, unfortunately, a little bit of super glue on the glass. I used the floor polish to stop it from crazing more than it did, but there is just a little bit on there, and you know, there's nothing I can do about it now. If I had thought about it in advance, I would have glazed the glass before I did anything with it, with that future floor polish, and that would have stopped my little mistake. But it happens. The kit goes together very, very well. The tonneau cover just drops in. You can still pull it out and put the hard top on if you desire. You can display it either way. That's why I completed the hard top, and we'll see. It is turning, so it might be a little difficult, but the tonneau cover will come right off, and the hard top just pops right on. So you can see how it looks like a little baby vet there going on. It's a very sweet looking ride. I kind of prefer it with the tonneau cover, which just falls in. You don't even need to put the tonneau cover on because we paint it underneath where it goes, and that just goes into place there. It looks pretty tough, and then we can see that nice red interior. When I placed the chassis into the body, I did have to squeeze the doors in to get them to fit flush, and then it clicked all the way down. But I was having a heck of a time getting the body down, realized the doors weren't sitting flush with the exterior door, and then said, oh, okay, and took a very thin screwdriver, pushed the doors in so the body would snap on there, which is general test and fit. The grille, the headlights, the side logos, those are slick. The door handles, the trunk hitches, Everything just pops into place like it should. The bumpers are held in their holes with friction. Didn't need to do anything. Everything looks awesome underneath with the white in the exhaust. I mean, it was just that Tamiya engineered it quite well and didn't give me fits. We can still get the hood open, but it is such a tight fit. You're going to need a very thin tool to lift it up every time. And, you know, you're going to need that. So that's why I took pictures of the chassis with the body off, so you could see the engine and everything underneath it. And we could see the inner hood glued on, because getting that hood to come up, if you don't want to leave it sitting a little proud, is going to need a hobby knife or a very thin knife to pry that up every single time. Otherwise, the kit's awesome. The interior looks so sweet with that dashboard and that mirror and that windshield brace and the windshield wipers. Make sure you glue them in so that the windshield wipers are aiming to the passenger side, because this is right-hand drive. So match the manual, match the box art. You want to make sure you get that right, or most people wouldn't notice it, but you'll notice because it is, you know, the convertible, and it is a right-hand drive. It is JDM, Japanese domestic market, so make sure you match it to that design. I love the kit. I want to thank Model Roundup for sending it over. They've got these in stock right now, so I will link in the description to grab yours. As always, thanks for watching the workshop, and we will see all of you at the next review.